Welcome to the PI2Pi interface introduction. The PI2Pi interface copies tag data from a source PI server to a second destination PI server, and it provides a very close copy of a PI server's tags for a variety of situations. The first is to make PI server data available to a business network so that users can access the data without altering the originals. A second use of the PI2Pi interface would be to set up a test PI server for development, and this allows you to test changes on a copy of the PI server first. A third common use is to pull data from many PI servers to a central PI server to allow for easier collaboration and a broader view of company data. There are three configurations to transfer data using the PI2Pi interface. The first one is where we push data from the source PI server onto the destination PI server, and the PI2Pi interface is located on the source. This allows us to use the PI buffer subsystem to buffer data to the source PI server. The second configuration is where data are pulled from the source PI server onto the destination PI server, and the interface is located on the destination PI server. And the third configuration, a third machine pulls data from the source PI server and then pushes it to the destination PI server. There are three modes of data transfer for the PI2Pi interface. The first is snapshot data collection. In this mode, the interface will sign up the tags for updates on the source PI server to receive snapshot values. The snapshot values accumulate in the update queue assigned to the interface on the source PI server. The second mode of data transfer is archive data collection. In this mode, the interface will query the source PI server archive for its data. The third mode is forced history recovery with start time and end time specified. This allows you to recover a data gap in the receiving PI server. In this mode, you will collect data within the specified time period and then stop. You can also use these modes together. The interface can be configured to run history recovery on startup and reconnect before proceeding with snapshot or archive data collection. Thank you for watching.